My name's Jovie Talbot, and I am a composer, and I wrote the music for Penelope.
I knew it. He's the one.
He just might be.
Hello.
The story of the film is that she's been born with this strangely deformed pig nose, and she never leaves the house. She's pretty much kept prisoner in her house by her well-meaning but ultimately fairly useless parents. The first time I met Mark Polanski, I went down to the shoot. He took me onto the set, and I was really struck by it. A really beautiful space, filled with incredible artworks, and the production designer did a really amazing job, and so I instantly knew that it was going to be an important job of the music to kind of create this magical world. So I was thinking about the palette of things that it might be useful to use. I was thinking of a very kind of golden, kind of shiny orchestral sound with some beautiful tinkling silvery gold noises, bells and things like that. And then also that there was this slightly menacing undercurrent. There's this character of Lemon, the reporter played by Peter Dinklage. And he had to have this rather slightly sinister, but ultimately quite amusing and weird music, which I scored with tuba, accordion, castanets, and something or other, just to try and create a really sort of a strange, disarming kind of sound world for this character. Well, the first film I did was commissioned by the British Film Institute. It was an old Alfred Hitchcock silent movie from the 20s called The Lodger that I had to score, and that was a kind of great introduction to the world of scoring for film. I'd worked with a couple of filmmakers in London called Hammer and Tongs, Garth Jennings and Nick Goldsmith, who are just wonderful. They were asked by Disney to direct Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, which was kind of my absolute obsessive favourite book when I was growing up, and they asked whether I could be the composer on it, and Disney, for some unknown reason, said, "Hey, this guy's never done a film before. All right." And so that was my first movie, and sort of taking it from there. With working with Mark Polanski, he was a very easy and nice director to work with, because he's very musical, and he had quite a strong idea about what he wanted, and he kind of instantly knew when he heard the demos whether they were what he was thinking on or not. And we had, we had early discussions about the sort of mood of the music, and also there's quite a lot of on-camera music in the film, and Max, the James McAvoy's character, plays piano, so it seemed clear that the music associated with him, the piano, would be quite a kind of prominent thing, and cause that sort of set us in the right direction, and then we went from there. One big moment in the film is when Penelope finally manages to break out of the house where she's been living all her life, and she goes out into the real world, and the real world through her eyes is this sort of absolutely amazing, fantastical place. It's she throws open the doors of the castle, and there's just real life, and to her it's just a dream world. So from that point in the film, the music really kind of needed to pick up and be really sort of magical and extraordinary. So I kind of held back on the full orchestral thing to that moment, and then kind of really let rip.